Alleluia. We have observed his star at its rising and have come to worship him. Alleluia. Almighty God, you led the wise men by the shining of a star to find the Christ, the light from light. Lead us also in our pilgrimage to find Christ. Amen. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer, for you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
God be with you. Let us pray. O God, by the leading of a star, you manifested your only Son to the peoples of the earth. Lead us who know you now by faith to your presence, where we may see your glory face to face, through Jesus Christ, our Savior, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. For darkness shall cover the earth, and thick darkness the peoples. But the Lord will arise upon you, and his glory will appear over you. Nations shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Lift up your eyes and look around. They all gather together. They come to you. Your sons shall come from far away, and your daughters shall be carried on their nurses' arms. Then you shall see and be radiant. Your heart shall thrill and rejoice, because the abundance of the sea shall be brought to you. The wealth of the nations shall come to you. A multitude of camels shall cover you, the young camels of Midian and Ephah. All those from Sheba shall come. They shall bring gold and frankincense and shall proclaim and praise the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will read Psalm 72 together. I give the king your justice, O God, and your righteousness to the king's son, that he may rule your people righteously and the poor with justice, that the nurse may bring prosperity to the peoples, and the little hills bring righteousness. He shall offend, he shall rescue the poor and nourish the oppressor. He shall give to son from one generation to another. He shall come down and train upon the moon yield and showers at the earth. In his prime shall the righteous flourish. There shall be abundance of peace till the moon shall be no more. The kings of Ashes shall and the kings of and Saba their gifts. All kings shall bow down before him, and all the nations do him sacrifice. He has the poor distress, and the oppressed who has no helper. He shall have pity on the lowly and poor. He shall the needy. He shall redeem the lives of oppression and violence, and they're in his sight.
This is the second reading from the book of the Ephesians. This is the reason that I, Paul, am a prisoner for Christ Jesus for the sake of your Gentiles. For surely you have already heard of the commission of God's grace that was given to me for you, and how the mystery was made known to me by revelation, as I wrote above in a few words, a reading of which will enable you to perceive my understanding of the mystery of Christ. In former generations, this mystery was not made known to humankind, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostle and prophets by the Spirit. That is, the Gentiles have become fellow heirs, members of the same body, and sharers in the promise of Christ Jesus through the gospel. Of this gospel, I have become a servant according to the gift of God's grace that was given to me by the working of his power. Although I am very least of all the saints, this grace was given to me to bring the Gentiles the news of boundless riches of Christ, and to make everyone see what is the plan of the mystery hidden for ages in God who created all things, so that through the church, the wisdom of God in its rich variety might now be made known to the rulers and authorities in the heavenly places. This was in accordance with the eternal purpose that has carried out in Christ Jesus our Lord, in whom we have access to God in boldness and confidence through faith in him. The word of God for the people of God.
Thank you. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Christ. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who's been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all of Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to be a shepherd for my people.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. And then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child. For when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. And then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. The season of Epiphany begins on Wednesday, January 6th. Epiphany comes from a Greek word meaning appearance, revelation, or manifestation, like the appearance of a divine being or the revelation of some essential truth. We use the word epiphany when something is suddenly made clear to us. Christians have been celebrating this feast day all the way back to the end of the second century. Back then, Egyptian Christians combined three separate biblical epiphanies that were considered manifestations of God and Christ. They were the visit of the Magi, the baptism of Jesus in the Jordan River, and Jesus' first recorded miracle at the wedding in Cana. This feast day and the whole season that follows celebrates God's presence, breaking through into humanity. It's the amazing gift of God reaching out, taking our hand, and assuring us that no matter how bleak the world gets, no matter how much we struggle and question, or how lost we feel, God is always there, guiding us. The gospel passages appointed during the season of Epiphany invite us to join Jesus on this journey of his inclusive and universal mission to all people. And so today, as we prepare for this brief but magnificent church season, we begin at the beginning, that initial seminal sign that Jesus is one for the whole world. We learn this fundamental truth through the story of the Magi and their journey from the east to worship Jesus Christ. These Magi come from a distant land, possibly Babylon, Persia, or Syria, and they are not of Jesus's tribe or his race or his nation. Israelites would have looked down upon them for being astronomers. God forbade the Israelites from using divination a long time ago. The term magi can also refer to magicians or sorcerers, two more professions clearly outlawed in the books of Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. These are people whose occupations were repeatedly condemned and prohibited throughout Scripture. And yet, Matthew tells us that they traveled from afar to pay homage to the newborn Christ. The Magi are here to remind us that we should not worry ourselves with who is and who is not acceptable to God. We are not to judge anyone based on their occupation, their tribe, their race, or background, because God can and does cross all of those barriers. Jesus Christ can and does appeal to all people, regardless if they are familiar with him or not. We should not worry whether or not we ourselves are good enough to worship God or celebrate God's love for us. God's love is not withheld from anyone. God loves all people, no matter what boundaries we may have set for them. If you are in the Episcopal Diocese of Fort Worth, you've likely heard this sermon before. Here we deeply believe that God loves all of us, that God doesn't hate any of us. But as we begin a new year, I thought it was worth repeating once again. Consider it my gift on this 10th day of the Christmas season. You thought the talk of giving and receiving was over now that Christmas Day is so far behind us, but not so fast. Epiphany brings up the importance of gift giving once more. For many of us, it's far easier for us to give than it is to receive. But that's where I call you to sit today, receiving the gifts that God gives to all of us. The gift of Jesus, whose love knows no boundaries. The gift of a church family who will stand by you and affirm you, even when your biological family may not. The gifts of grace, balance, generosity, forgiveness, and fellowship. These two are gifts from God, though admittedly they are harder to receive, harder to accept. Today, as we celebrate the Feast of the Epiphany, we will receive the gift of a star word. It's literally a piece of paper, a paper-shaped star with a word written on it. And the hope is that this gift of a star word will offer you a point of focus or inspiration for the year 2021. It's a gift that will allow us to experience God in an epiphany-like way. We introduced star words last year at St. Stephen's, and what a gift they have been to us. One member told me over the summer that her star word was love. She found herself looking for love between neighbors everywhere she went, seeing folks reach out safely to those who were isolated from the rest of the world, and watching random acts of kindness happen in the grocery store. Another member drew the word time and realized early on in the pandemic that physical distancing and staying home offered more time for her to spend in prayer. So she began praying the hours in community through Facebook Live and Lenten podcast, and on her own using the hour by hour prayer book. My star word for 2020 was rejoice. And I had no idea how grateful I would be for such a word when I drew it on Epiphany last year. As the pandemic wore on and on and on, I found myself intentionally looking for small acts of joy to celebrate. It became the word I used in centering prayer to call myself back to focus. It was the word I used in simple breathing prayers when I recognized my anxiety spiraling. This word, rejoice, wove itself into the fabric of my life last year. Many members of our church received a randomly chosen envelope holding their star 2 weeks ago, and they were invited to open it today. If you did not receive a star gift and would like one, just comment below or send one of us here an email, and I will happily send you one. We bought a lot extra to share. And know that you might find that your word seems quite timely. Or perhaps you might receive a word that you really don't like or understand. But if that's the case, please know that God often teaches us even when we are uncertain or resistant. Allow the word to speak to you. Look up its meaning in the dictionary. Search for where it's found throughout Scripture, and then place your star where you will see it often. Perhaps by your at-home desk, work computer, where we spend so much time these days, or on your refrigerator or your bathroom mirror. Take a photo of your star and use it as your phone wallpaper. Ponder your star word, as Mary pondered the shepherd's stories in her heart that first Christmas morning. Let it rest within you. As human beings, we all long for an epiphany. We long for a sign that God is with us. And typically, I find myself so consumed with life that I fail to notice God's manifestations right in front of me. But one of the surprising elements of the pandemic is the forced opportunity to slow down. I'm seeing things that I never did before and rejoicing over them. This year, consider this star word a gift to help you focus your awareness of God's presence in your life. Consider it a gift to guide you, as that star did for the Magi so long ago. May it guide you to a place where you discover God breaking into the world in powerful and personal ways. Receive this gift, along with the gifts of God's grace and peace, and then share it with others. Share them without concern over whether they have the right occupation or the right nationality. God's love transcends all boundaries that we might create around people. Follow the star, because you never know where it might lead you. Amen.
Let us join with believers around the world as together we profess our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again. In accordance with the Scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray for the church and for the world.
Almighty God, grant that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. We pray for Justin, the Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, the presiding bishop of the Episcopal Church, Scott, our bishop, and for all bishops, ministers, and lay leaders. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, especially Donald, our president, Joe, our president-elect, Greg, our governor, and Betsy, our mayor, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. We pray for Four Saints Episcopal Food Pantry, East Side Ministries, and other nonprofits that care for your beloved. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Joy of human hearts, heal our human communities, especially those where your word is not heard or where neglect, violence, greed, and warfare increase the suffering and need of people and other creatures. Protect and guide those who serve in the military and those who are first responders. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Comforter of all the earth, bless those worshiping with us today and any looking for a place to belong. Sustain the people who need your presence and help especially those we now name. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend to your mercy all who have died, that your will for them may be fulfilled, and we pray that we may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom. Christ, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Let us pray also for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful God. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through the grace of Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ taught us, together we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
Peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, Creator, Redeemer, and Sanctifier, rest upon you this moment and remain with you always. Amen. Let us go forth rejoicing in the power of the Spirit. Thanks be to God.